Virginia Henry, and I'm just kind of battling the elements at the moment, and I hope that we have pretty good cell reception. Kind of been off and on a little bit today, so we'll see what happens and hope for the best. And I don't know, I hope that this is all working, everything's good. Okay, we're on. Yay, hi guys, good to see you. Okay, so I'm here at the Atlantic and I'm having a ball. It's gorgeous today. Look at the color of this water. Good to see you guys. So I just have my setup. It's a really basic, simple one today. And hey guys, I just have just an 8x10 canvas, so I'm gonna move y'all in quite a bit closer. And but it is gonna be fun. I think we're gonna have fun with this today. It is gonna be. It's a smaller one, so we'll be up close. But I've got gorgeous colors, and we're gonna have a lot of fun. I'll do kind of a close up of one of these waves. Okay, so let's jump in. I'm gonna move you up here. Real close. Hopefully we maintain cell reception because it's been kind of touch and go today. So I have one of my palettes here. These you guys are well aware that they are available on my website. So I have all my regular colors, titanium white, cadmium yellow pale. And if these two look different, it's because they are. One is cad yellow pale and the other one is just cad medium. I don't know why, I just happen to squeeze it up. Yellow ochre, burnt sienna, ultramarine blue, you can see on there, this way, phthalo green, and alizarin crimson. So sort of a, well, if you take alizarin crimson and phthalo green, you get kind of a brown. So by adding a little bit of that brown into that blue I thought was too bright, it just neutralized it. So if you're asking questions, I can't see. Oh, you can hear me, good. You thought you saw a fin? You probably did, Ted.
I love it.
on the surface after that. And as I do the crest of the wave, I'll talk about that a little bit too. So that's what I'm doing right here. I'm kind of painting the color that I see under the highlights when I look out there. I think it needs to be a little brighter here. Hope everybody had a good couple weeks. I missed you guys all last week. Thought about you. Thank you. quickly before I lose that out of my head. The top of the wave was darker, so I'm going to get a little bit of that blue, brown, green right on top in here. But this is the part of that passage where I was talking about working on an underlayer underneath stuff. Jess, do you have, the indigo thing. Yep. I just posted a thing yesterday, last night, that had a picture of me, and then if you scroll down, the link to that GoFundMe site with Indiegogo is right on there, and there's not very many days left, so if you're interested in helping out in our Paint Your Adventure journey, that would be awesome. And appreciate it. I've got some really fun gifts for different levels. So you just have to go to my Facebook timeline and check that out. So here, I have this. It's a little bit too green. I think I'm going to add some burnt sienna into my yellow ochre in that mixture, because it's just kind of more like a brownie sand color in this wave in here. Yeah, that's about right. And you'll notice I jump all over this picture because I'm trying to capture all kinds of different things. When I get the color just right, or a color, I'll look over there and see where else it is, and I'll put that down. Sometimes the value shifts a little bit lighter. Yeah, right in there. So I've got some more white here. I just keep these puddles on my palette just mixed up, and I just jump into them as needed, judging where I see. Whether it's the ocean or a lake, Now I'm at all.
Well, thank you, Ron.
Those are some pretty big shoes to follow. All right. I noticed when I looked out there that there's this beautiful baby blue periwinkle pieces like this color. I hope you can see that. This is so pretty. And I'm going to thin that down with a little bit of linseed oil. I am using some more linseed oil today because when it's a little bit, it's like 74 degrees, which is nice, but my paint still wants to be a little bit stiffer when it's a little chilly. So it's not chilly, but my paint thinks it is. It's hard to argue with that. Okay, so I see this back in here, and I'm just going to pop in, I love that. A little bit of those little blue where the sky is reflecting on the surface of the water. I say it's okay to get excited about brush strokes. Painting pomegranate seeds. Oh my gosh. Love that. So pretty. Alright. Don't want to overdo it. It's easy to do. But, hey guys. I'm seeing some of that. So the wave crest and I have a dark passage, but then the sky is hitting this right here. And now I'm going to think about this passage in here as like a tabletop. So I'm thinking about the strokes coming out like this. A little more white in there because it's getting that sky blue feel. It's getting the sky hitting it. So let's get some more oil. When I get the oil, I just take a drop on the edge of my brush, mix it in. If I need more, I can go get more, but you don't want to get too much. So just a little bit's all you need. Thank you. doing a few dark accents and I'm almost done. Just ultramarine blue, burnt sienna, just to make a nice dark, maybe some purple. I call it purple, I mean alizarin crimson. Just to get some of those little anchor pieces. Popping those in. The paint is now flying. Slinging paint today. Okay, that's feeling like wet sand there. I'm happy with that. And then under the wave over here, pop in some little fish. Alright, well I think that that's about as far as I'm going to take it today. Obviously I could play and have more fun and goof off. Probably ruin it. Alright, well anyway, I want to thank you guys so much for joining and have a great weekend.